I love Jenkins, KaHobby, and Budgie.
Hello mga KaHobby, welcome back sa ating channel. Dito tayo ngayon sa bahay ng isa sa kilala at sikat na mag-iibon, particularly sa species ng Budgie. Doon siya in sa Budgie. Mapapakilala ko sa inyo ngayon, pasok tayo sa bahay nila. Mga KaHobby, pinapakilala ko po sa inyo si Sir Robert Jenkins. At saka siyempre si Chairman Julius, yun na meet nyo na. Yung unang tinature natin na international judge sa virtual competition, kasama po natin siya ngayon. Sir, can you introduce yourself?
Yes. I'm Robert Jenkins according to my passport, but I've always been called my last name Raymond from a young child. I've been living here now in the Philippines since 2012, although I built the house here in 2006 in preparation for my retirement. I have been breeding budgies since 1975. In the UK, I started with about four pairs, and I bred for about 2 years, and then I gave them up at that time because I went to work abroad. I went to work in Iran for 2 years. I started breeding again in 1982, and I continued until I again gave up the birds in 1996 when my wife contacted me, my first wife, contracted breast cancer. My love of the budgies has been ever since I was a child. I went once to visit an aunt with my mother, and I had no idea they had birds, but in an aviary in the back garden they had a mixture of budgerigars and also British finches. And my second favourite bird is the goldfinch, the British goldfinch. At that time, my auntie had some fantastic coloured dark greens, and I fell in love with them then. So I knew that in later life, at some stage, I would take up bird breeding. I joined the BS and the Welsh BS in the middle of the 80s, and I advanced from beginner to intermediate, and was successful on the show bench. I took several best in shows at local events. I had an exceptionally good Sky Blue once, and she won two best in shows for me.
Sir, what is your favorite mutation?
My favorites have always been normals of any color. I'm not too keen on opalins, and the red eyes, I've always felt that it's too long a period in improving the quality, and also there's too much waste with them. Same with all recessive varieties. It takes you years and years to produce good quality from mediocre birds. And of course, when you start off, everybody has mediocre birds. They don't have the best. I don't inbreed very much at all. I'm out crossing most of the time, because I've been a firm believer in, if you're going to inbreed, you must already have very high quality birds. Because if you have inferior quality birds and you inbreed, all you're doing is breeding all the inferiority complexes and genes back into the same family. You're not really going up at all. Your quality will hardly ever improve. So I stick with outcrossing, and I've been fairly successful with it. When you see some of my birds later now, I'm sure you will agree with me.
In terms of inbreeding, sir, how on up to how many generations you can inbreed?
Well, in proper inbreeding is the breeding of very, very close relatives. That means father to daughter, mother to son, half-brother to half-sister. That's proper inbreeding, where you're breeding the blood in very close. And the problem with that is that if there is any inherent problems in the birds, that will come out. So you have that in the blood then. That's why close inbreeding is not good, especially for inexperienced budgie breeders. Line breeding is slightly different, where you breed with birds of the same family, but further apart. Cousins, aunties, uncle to nephew, uncle to niece, those type of things. And then second cousins and even back to a grandfather or a great-grandfather. But that's a better direction to go. But again, you shouldn't start line breeding until you have birds of very good quality. Otherwise, all you're doing is reproducing mediocre birds.
To secure the quality of your birds, do you import birds from other countries?
I've been part of a couple of imports in the last couple of years here. I started here in the Philippines in 2005. I had a few birds from Paul Vidal and from Paul de Jesus. But after 2 years, I decided to go back to Saudi to work. So I sold all those birds. When I returned in 2012, I was determined to start again. So by the time I got settled back in the Philippines and got my home all settled and down with the family, I started in late 2014 to purchase birds. I'd already built the bird room. I again went to my very good friend Paul Vidal, and I bought some birds from him. And then I went to Rudy Kayanen, and I bought quite a few birds from Rudy. Rudy at that time was certainly one of the leading breeders here. And even the birds I bought weren't of top quality. They were nice birds. And I decided that I would work with those for a while. And then I was invited to be part of an import from Paul Stannard in the UK, which I accepted, and I had some birds from there. Unfortunately, most of the birds were unsuccessful for me. Two or three died very quickly, and two cocks didn't breed at all for over 2 years, 2.5 years. And then suddenly one of them produced 3 full eggs, and that was his last. But the other cock then bred for me about 16 chicks. So in the end, I bred some nice spangles from that bird.
Breeding budgies is not that easy.
Breeding budgies is very, very easy if you have very mediocre stock, similar to Keats. But if you have the higher the standard of bird you produce, the higher the quality you want, the more difficult, the more hazards you come up against. It's, again, mainly down to the fact that you have birds that have been inbred in other aviaries, and they've been bred to be bigger produce more feather. All of these things in turn cause problems for you.
Do you sell birds, sir? Do you sell
birds?
How much a budgie cost?
I don't give any prices. If someone is interested in one of my birds, they will contact me and I will give them a price. Oh. I don't specify prices anymore. And again, whatever the price would be, it would be dependent on what bloodline it has and the visual quality. Now, I say that because if you're going to buy a bird, and it may be from a good bloodline, if it looks absolutely terrible, you can't charge a high price for it just because it's got a good bloodline. You want it to have something to look at, something that gives you a nice visual appearance as well as a bloodline. Because anybody that is wanting to buy wants to see something in front of them. They don't want to see an ordinary bird and say, oh, but this is out of my two best birds and they cost me blah, blah, blah. And this is why the price is high. You have to, I moderate it to the quality of the bird as well as the bloodline.
How do you take care of the birds, sir? What are you, the supplements that you give them for breeding?
I breed 60% canary mixed with 40% mixed millets. And I feed the soft food into the mixture basically of soaked oats, carrots, and a few supplements like porridge oats, crumbs, dog food, and a calcium supplement in the soft food. Vitamins, I had a very successful time running for two years, but my birds were getting so fit that I started to find that a few of my hens were getting too aggressive to the chicks. I didn't lose many that were killed, but I lost one or two. But I decided then that I must be feeding too high a percentage of vitamins and minerals. So I decided to change it and cut it right back. As soon as I cut it back, I found that the hens were fine, the cocks were fine, they weren't harming the chicks at all. But I must have cut it back too hard because I was finding then that I was getting the birds weren't fit enough and I was getting a lot of empty eggs. So I've only just embarked now on a new schedule for my water, vitamins and minerals. I won't say what that is yet because I don't know how successful it's going to be. But things are looking better. I've now got quite a few full eggs coming up in the boxes, which I'm very happy with.
Can you give an inspirational talk for our viewers?
I would encourage anybody that is thinking of starting as a newbie in this hobby that they go to quite a lot of aviaries before they even think of purchasing birds. Look at the birds in many aviaries, assess the quality that is being bred in the aviaries. Ask the prices to have an idea of what you've got or what you can get for your budget, and don't rush into buying stock. Think very hard before you buy it, because your money is hard earned and it's soon lost. Don't buy too many birds to start with. You only want to start with about 4 or 6 pairs. Once you've learned how to feed them and look after them properly, and the bird you've bought to start with may be mediocre, then if you sell your young one, you can use that money perhaps to buy 1 or 2 better birds for the next year. And if you continue to do that, you slowly build up the quality of your stock. It's not easy. It's not going to happen overnight, and it's certainly not going to happen in 2 or 3 years. It's going to take you a long time. But if you're dedicated, you'll get there in the end.
here are some of the supplements and medication that Robert Jenkins is using in his aviary. This is Spectrum Powder Multivitamin Supplement. Before, I am using this. Very effective also.
I hope that it's the pin for the going like bird.
No, not bird.
For the bumper.
Oh, what it was called? Fresh.
So, yeah, fresh. And the fungal.
Ay, sa ano? How's that?
Para bumper sa alapate. And this ibomet for the different kinds of work.
And I'm using, I also use that. It can also cure bugs.
He is using quality imported products. Yeah, yan yung mga gamit niya.
Because we are using micro.
That's our interview with idol Robert Jenkins. If you're planning to buy quality Budgie material, look for him. And I guarantee you the top quality of his stocks. Thank you, fellow hobbies, for watching our channel and continue supporting us. God bless us all.